The industrial automation market is one that is set to be constant growth for many years. There are plenty of reasons for this. The most basic one goes around the fact that industry always in need of processes optimization and revenue. Right now, they are obtaining this by looking for ways to reduce shutdown time as little as possible. And this comes at hand with optimum error handling and a more skilled workforce. Hey, what's up guys? Ehsan here with Power In, helping you go further and faster in electrical engineering. And if you are new here, consider subscribing. Now let's go back to the topic. Having a skillful workforce is not easy to control. That is why another trend of the market is making PLCs based systems easier to use. In general, the modernization of the market is what they are aiming for. It's not secret that technology in the consumer world advances faster in the industrial sector. Although this does not mean the industrial sector is not looking to make more advanced devices. It is just they don't want to do it at the expense of reliability and long-term installation. At the end of the day, as long as industry has problems to be solved, the PLC market is going to keep growing. And this growth is actually certain due to the fierce competition between the bigger names of the market. According to research by Murder Intelligence, the PLC market was worth almost $4 billion in 2019. It is expected to reach $4.3 billion by 2025 at an annual growth rate of 3.7% over Murder's forecast period of 2020 to 2025. A large portion of the growth is expected to come from automotive manufacturing sector, where PLCs first emerged, and the sector that use more industrial robots than any other. In the term of geographical region, Mordor estimate that the US is likely to see the strongest growth in demand for PLCs because of the increased emphasis by governments on manufacturing, as well as the rise in investment in the mining and oil and gas sector. The US is included with Canada as a region that we will see what Mordor say will be high growth in demand for PLC. The other countries that we will have high growth include China, India, Australia, and Japan. Europe is regarded by Mordor to have high level prospect for growth, partly because it is already an advanced industrial region and is a home to many of largest manufacturing nations in the world. We should caution that while we feel confident that we have listed the top 5, we cannot say that the order of the top 5 is rigorously scientific. The criteria we use included sales, adoption, market share, awareness level, discoverability online, and so on, whatever we could find. Journalism is more of an art than science anyway. That's our excuse. Having said that, we have done our best to highlight the main companies and the essence of their offering, as well as some pertinent details, at least some of which we hope you will find useful. If you are still enjoying this video, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. And now it's the time to name 5 top companies. Number 1, Siemens. Estimated by some to be clear leader in PLC, Siemens has approximately 30 to 40% market share depending on which report you to believe. Although these estimates are based on aggregating the top 5 or so, which together are said to sell far more of the devices than all the rest put together. Europe's largest engineering company, with a market capitalization of the almost $124 billion and revenue of $60 billion a year. German giant Siemens says its Sematic range has a controller for every application. The Sematic S7-1500 offers a future-proof solution thanks to its modular nature, and high performance. Then the Smatic S7-1200 offer a better approach for lower medium range application looking for full features devices. Lastly, they have their line of distributed controller for distributed design and small spaces. Number 2, Rockwell Automation or Allen Bradley. Rockwell Automation acquired Allen Bradley for approximately $1.6 billion in 1985. It was a lot of money back then, and it would be a lot of money now. But the value of Allen Bradley is raised by the fact that it is a historical brand founded in 1903, the same year as Rockwell. In fact, the two American firms have always been somewhat intertwined and follow the same path on their journey to become what is now, as a combined unit, one of the world's largest industrial automation companies. It is PLC offering range from large down to tiny nanosystems. Its market capitalization is $25 billion and its annual revenue are around $7 billion. Number 3, Mitsubishi Electric. With a market cap of around $28 billion, Mitsubishi Electric is the one of the larger business units of the giant conglomerate that is Mitsubishi Group, with a staggering 350,000 employees. In 2017, Mitsubishi Electric's annual revenue was $37 billion, which is obviously more than its current market cap, so there have been ups and downs. Nonetheless, it is one of the largest manufacturers of PLCs, with arguably the widest range, and its Japan headquarters are in region where fast growth is predicted. Number 4, Schneider Electric. Arguably not as well known outside of the industrial sector as other in this list, partly because it doesn't have any consumer product of note. Schneider Electric is nonetheless a leading provider of PLCs. Modicon, one of Schneider Electric's brands, believed to have produced the first PLC in the US back in 1968. Then saw a series of merge and acquisition. Schneider Electric merged in 1999. Today, Schneider Electric, a French company, employs 135,000 people, has a market cap of around $35 billion, and generates annual revenue of more than $27 billion, of course in euro. Number 5, and the last one, ABB. The Swedish industrial giant has enjoyed spectacular success in recent years, at least in terms of flair with which it has launched many new products. From what is described as the world's first truly collaborative robot, the two-armed Yumi, to its industrial Internet of Things platform Evolut, and its 50 billion market cap, 28 billion annual revenues, and 144,000 employees shows that there is plenty of substance behind the style. ABB is also one of the world's largest manufacturer of industrial robots, so it's followed that it has a wide range of PLC on offer. If you have any suggestion or information that may strengthen this video, please feel free to comment below and contribute your knowledge in what it is fundamental technology industrial automation. Finally, if you are curious how much does a PLC programmer makes in the US, UK, Canada, and Germany, be sure to don't miss this awesome video. Have a good time and see you soon. Bye.